أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وأهل بيته وبارك وسلم. وصل على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى كل ملائكة المقربين وعلى عباد الله الصالحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. فقال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله نور السماوات والأرض. يا أيها النبي إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. صدق الله العلي العظيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I greet you with the universal greetings of peace, justice, and sacrifice. We glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we thank Him. For surely if Allah didn't guide us, we would never have uttered the word of Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. After we praise and glorify Allah, we ask the Almighty Allah to put His peace and blessings and salutation on our Master, our final Prophet, our leader, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And also put His salutation on all the Prophets before Him, their families and friends that stood with them, and all those who gave their lives in the path of Allah. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam and beloved ulama, we ask you to listen to us today, for today we are going to speak about the topic of light, Noor. And how does this Noor going to impact on our lives? Firstly, Allah says in His Quran in Surah 24 Al-Noor, Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. The light of Allah, if we will compare it, if we look at the existence or the creation of the Almighty Allah, then we will see, if we look at the earth, the moon and the stars in our planet, in our Milky Way, in our galaxy that we exist, and if we take everything around it that exists, then if you look and you want to find the galaxy that man or that we love, for the galaxy that we are existing in, and it lost, we are lost in it, we can't even find it. We put the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together. And we look at this and we marvel the creation of the Almighty Allah, the Noor that we see in the heavens and the stars and the Milky Way. If we take all of this and want to understand the light of the Almighty God of Allah, it's like putting your finger in the ocean, and that drop of water on your finger is the creation of the Noor of Allah. And the rest of the ocean is the Noor of Allah. So man will never comprehend the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran explained to us this light, how this light works on different levels. And the one position that Allah takes, that Allah says, Allah has created the prophets, and they are the light which Allah has created for mankind. Allah says that Nabi Isa, Jesus, was sent with the light and with the book of light in the original form. That Moses was the light, Nabi Musa was the light, and the Torah and Injil in its original form, it was the light. Then Allah speaks about Al-Quran, which is the light, which Allah speaks about, of the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah had blessed some places on the earth, which Allah had blessed, and you will find light around these places that Allah had blessed. But then Allah also speaks about those who stand up for righteousness and justice in the world under the banner of belief, that they are the light. They are light to themselves in the path of Allah, and they are light for mankind. Then Allah addressed in the Quran, in the holy book, the final chapter, the final Quran, the final book of Allah, that Allah speaks of the shuhada. Allah said that the shuhada is the light which Allah speaks in the Quran. Then Allah addressed in different places in the Quran. Allah says in Surah Ibrahim, Surah 15, verse 1, Alif Lam Ra, a book which we have revealed unto thee in order that thou mayest lead mankind out of the depth of darkness into the light by the leave of your Lord, to the way, the exalted in power, worthy of all praise. So the Quran was revealed for one purpose, and one purpose only, is to lead mankind out of the depth of darkness into the light. Which light? That we must worship the Almighty Allah. This is what the Quran was revealed for. Then the Quran speaks on another occasion. It says, O you who believe, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, fear Allah and believe in His Apostle, and He, Allah, will bestow on you a double portion of His mercy, and He will provide for you a light by which you shall walk straight into in His path, and He will forgive you, for Allah is forgiving and most merciful. The question that has been asked to ourselves, I'll ask the question myself, how do I find this light? And how do I walk into this light which Allah sends to mankind? There's another place in the Quran which Allah says, when the second trumpet is blown, there will only be, when men look around them, there will be the light which Allah will descend on the second trumpet that is blown. Then Allah addressed in another place in the Quran, Allah says to those who have found this light, to the true believers, when they walk Qiyamah to find their book either in the right hand or in the left hand, when mankind will be given what you have been living at, those who truly submit to Allah, this light will be running in front of you. It will run in front of you, and it will remain in front of you. The prophets and the angels, they will know that you are coming because the light that is in front of you. The angels, Allah said, He created them out of light. How do we walk in this nur? How do we sit and talk and eat and live and sleep in this light which the Almighty God, the Almighty Allah speaks about? The only way you can walk in this light, and the only way that this light will be with you. You can drive on the road, the light will be with you. Allah will put that light with you. You will live in that nur. How do we attain it? This is the question. We can only attain this light if we implement the book of Allah in its complete form. If you take one verse or one chapter symbolically out and you don't love it, you can never walk in the true nur of Allah. If you add something to this book that's not in this book, then you can never walk in the true nur of the Almighty Allah. This light is not that if you make salah, you make prayer, you go on pilgrimage, you fast, and you believe in Allah that you're automatically going to walk in this light. No. Everything that you do, your foundation of everything must be based on sincerity, truth, justice, fairness, righteousness, and honesty. You cannot walk in this nur of Allah if you support your family and friends if they are away from Allah. If they are involved in drugs, in gangsterism, or they are involved in sexually molesting our children, or they are involved in gambling, or you lie, or you dishonest, you cannot walk in this light of Allah. Today we must ask ourselves, where do we fit into this nur, on this light which Allah speaks about? We find mankind in darkness. We found our institutions, which God's name must be mentioned, the synagogue, the temples, the churches and mosques, we find that people have come to church, they come to mosques, to the synagogues, but they don't make a true connection with the light of Allah. Today you must ask yourself, deep inside of yourself, what is inside of you that is keeping you away from this light? If the Almighty Allah asks you to fast in the month of Ramadan, you must fast. If you ask you to give charity, you must give charity. But also if Allah asks you to fight against oppression, you must fight against oppression and injustice. Because if you don't do it, you have selectively applied the Quran. Even if you are fearful to stand up, you yourself have to acknowledge within yourself that there's a shortcoming in you and that you have to address it. At least if you cannot stand up, speak up about it. Or make a prayer for those who are oppressed in the land. Today we want to address one of the components of light. And one of the components of light is the shuhada. Because we see what's happening in the world. And we find that believing men and women, they put themselves in camps. And because they are in camps, they condemn other people that have given their lives in the cause of Allah. And they went even so far to say that people is not even believers. They are disbelievers. And they're going to hell. This is what mankind is projecting. Now we want to remind you today, people like Sayyidina Umar, peace be upon him, Uthman and Ali, peace be upon him, they are the people of light. They gave their lives. The Ahlul Bayt the Quran speaks of is light, it's nur. They have a special place in the book of Allah, in the sight of Allah. So if we mention the Ahlul Bayt and people, what's happening? No, the Ahlul Bayt belong to Islam. It belongs to Allah. It belongs to Quran. It belongs to the believers. Those who want to sway us, speak about Ahlul Bayt, we want to tell you today that the Ahlul Bayt gave life in the path of Allah. And they are the nur of Allah. So, is Sayyidina Hamza. These people gave life. But let us come and the Sahabas, Ikram, that gave their life in Uhud and Badr in all those battles. But let us look at the contemporary issues. They slaughtered Sheikh Yasin, the blind Sheikh. In Palestine, he's blind and was paralyzed. He was sitting in a wheelchair and they bombed him out of the air to smithers. And yet we forgot. They killed Anwar al-Awlaki. They bombed him with a drone and they killed him. They killed his children. And what do we do? Some of us wants to condemn openly, publicly, Sheikh Anwar al-Awlaki, Sheikh Anwar al-Awlaki. We say, where are we going? Qasim Soleimani, killed by America, brutally with other people. Yet we find amongst the so-called believers wants to tell us that this person is not a believer. But this person in itself slaughtered not hundreds, thousands of American troops in the Middle East. What is happening with us? We want to be intense. We are believers, we are Muslims. We are the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This division that we see amongst us, it's a division that's forced onto us. Wars is fought. Our lands have been invaded. Kuwait, Qatar, Saudi, Bahrain, Iraq, Africa. It's all bases of America, Britain, and Israel, and France, and other countries. Yet we are divided. We cannot see. And we are not searching for this light because we are narrowly looking at what madhab or school of thought we come in from. And we want to tell this to the Shias and the Sunnis. Anwar al-Awlaki belongs is our martyr. If you like it or you don't like it, it is our martyr. It's our light in the path of Allah. And those who hate Sulaimani, we want to tell you, he is our light in the earth, our martyr that have given blood. It is time that the Muslims unite and we fight all forms of oppression. Our children in this part of the world is being raped by gangsters and drug dealers. Our children goes into gangsterism. Yet we want to make 600 million Muslims non-believers. If there is amongst those that curse Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, and Sayyidina Uthman, we must distance ourselves from them. But you cannot, because a person belongs to a school of thought. Therefore, you condemn 600 million people. If someone in PAGAD is a thief, and we expel him, as we did, and extort money from people, and they move out of the nur of Allah, you cannot blame the organization. You cannot blame everyone that's in the movement. It's by time that we apply our akal, that we apply our senses that the Almighty Allah has given. given us. It's time to rise in the world against the forces that's killing Muslims, Christians, and all other nations in the world. It is time that we stand up. They don't ask you when they kill you. If they run against you in Venezuela, they don't ask you if you're Christian. If they create a government to overthrow you and kill your people, when they want to run against you in Iran, or in Iraq, or Sudan, they don't ask you if you're Muslim or what mazhab you belong. They kill your men, women, and children. Iraq, 500 children. 500 children, half a million children was killed by the invasion of America. Children, and they justify it as collateral damage. Yet some of you say that what America does is right. How far have you walked and gone away from this life? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring this ummah to this nur which Allah speaks about in the Quran.
Amen.
And that this ummah, if they are in this light, we will lift up the whole world. We will bring the world to peace, to sharing, to joy, to justice, to care, security. We will bring people that there will be plenty to eat, and we will live in harmony. The world is waiting on us, yet we are confused. We want to kill one another. America, Britain, France, Israel, where their counterparts in the Muslim world have killed not only Muslims, millions and tens of millions of Muslims and Christians and other people of faith. And yet we find it that we can say that America is right. My brothers in Islam and my sisters, in conclusion, I want to say, concentrate, think globally and concentrate locally. What are we going to do with the problem that is in front of us? What are we going to do? You must ask yourself this, and I must ask myself this. You sitting here today listening to me. There's a child that needs help. There's tens of thousands, thousands of children that need help. Mothers that's crying. Fathers sitting at home don't know what to do. Yet we have time to waste, to spill filth and venom for your own believing brother in Islam and sister. You can kill your own brother's child in a mosque, and they bomb a mosque because he says La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this light. The dua we make today is ربنا أتمن لنا نورنا واغفر لنا ربنا أتمن لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. Oh Lord, perfect our light for us and grant us forgiveness. For Thou is power of all things. The day we begin to move as one and we're going to sort out our difference, we are going to bring mankind to a level that they're waiting for many, for hundreds of years. I want to thank the Imam and the Mosque Committee for giving us this opportunity to deliver this khutbah, inshallah. May Allah put in all our hearts to change. First in ourselves, for you cannot take drugs and you want to fight in the cause. For you cannot gamble and want to fight in the cause of Allah. You cannot zina or watch pornographic movies and want to fight in the cause of Allah. Please, my brothers, find yourself in a place where Allah is going to be pleased with you. I greet you with the greetings. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Takbir!
Allahu akbar!
Takbir!
Allahu akbar!
Takbir!
Allahu akbar!